Hi everyone, this is Cubastic. Today I have on my desk the most incredible thing. This is the model of the most popular puzzle of the 19th century. This is a very old puzzle with an incredible history, with an incredible way of solving that proves that solving puzzles is not just difficult, but also very interesting. Mathematically complex puzzle, Tower of Hanoi. This puzzle was invented by the French mathematician Edouard Luca in 1982. They were selling it as a fun toy, and it was originally even called differently. The name was Professor Klaus of Lesuzian College, but it was later revealed that neither the professor nor the college existed, and in the abbreviation the name of the creator is encrypted. Only great minds could solve this puzzle in the smallest number of moves, and they found this number using hard mathematical equations. There are at least four ways to solve this puzzle, and they even found a special mathematical equation, a formula that calculates the minimum number of moves. It sounds like this: 2 to the power of the number of the rings, there are 8. 2 to the 8 power minus 1, that's 255 moves. As you can see, a simple puzzle holds much more interesting than we can think of. And so, in any puzzle, there is its story, there is its complexity, there is its mathematical formula, and so many other secrets. In the end, I will tell you an interesting legend about this puzzle, but now let's try to solve the Hanoi Tower, at least making 255 moves. But something tells me it's going to take me much more. As any puzzle, this one also has its conditions. Our job is to move the entire tower to any other rod for the least amount of moves. In this case, we can move only one ring in one turn and place only a smaller ring on top of the bigger one. That is, we can put the smaller ring on top, but we cannot put the bigger one on the smaller ring. And naturally, you can put any ring on an empty rod as a base. It's not a puzzle that requires timing, but I will. You can write down in the comments how long you think it will take me to solve it and how many moves I will need. This is where you need to count your moves. Let's start. All in all, it is clear that this can be done like this. There is a simpler version of this puzzle with only 4 rings. It was popular in America, but in this case there are 8 rings. And something tells me that if I do the same thing over and over again, like this, I'm going to be able to solve this puzzle sooner or later. But there is a big risk that when we get close to the last rings, I'm likely to get very confused. I moved half of the pyramid very quickly. Is this the mathematical way I have to shift it like this? Moving it one by one. Oh, we add additional action with each layer, with each move. Oh, there are a lot of extra things we can do, and when we're down here at the bottom, you can just get lost. Already on the 5th ring, I used a lot of moves. Remember, the first ring was easy, one move, the second ring, two moves. The third ring requires in geometric progression a greater number of movements. And the same with the 5th ring. Now the number of moves on the 6th can be much bigger, and on the 7th and on the 8th too. So the hardest thing here is this last ring. We will move the same way and use the same pattern. I mean, look what I'm doing. I release, first I unload our ring as much as possible, then I make room here, keep unloading our ring, then calmly, look, I think I'm already confused. Right now our job is to free our bottom one somehow. This is where I'm beginning to get confused, and very strongly, by the way. And this one here, I almost got the bottom one. Yes, I got the bottom one, now I can put the bottom one on the 6th ring, and now this tower needs to be moved here. And I'm still stick to all the rules. Not moving the bigger ring on a smaller one. Yes. Yes. That's it. Whew. Well, it was only 6 rings. God, how great it was. Look, I've already developed a real math tactic. I'm just shifting it, doing the same thing, but every next time I'm doing a lot more. They change among themselves. The position of the rings I make changes. The rods I put these rings on change. But still, the mathematical formula and the sequence of actions remain the same. 5 minutes have passed. The 7th ring, the penultimate. Here we go. I got lost. Wow, now I have to move the tower from here, here. I managed to move it and then I have to move the last one, but as you can see, it takes a huge amount of moves. I think I put this tower on the next one and I had to put it on this one. Jeez, I did work for nothing, it turns out. One more time. I moved another one. All this time I was moving only the first one. Wow. Crazy. My god, and imagine having so great mind that you can calculate all this mathematically. To make it all into one algorithm, into one formula that you can act on. I mean, it's just crazy. What kind of geniuses were these mathematicians? This tower is gradually growing and we're moving this one. This is what we need so far. One moment. Now that's right here, that's right here. Come on. That's right here, the last one. Ooh, that's crazy. By the way, it took me 13 minutes. I lost count, or rather I didn't count at all. Write in the comments how many moves you think I did. Now our task is to place this last 8th largest disc under the entire tower. But in case not to move the tower several times, we put the disc with the base on the middle pole, and here we will put our tower. Now I'm moving parts completely differently. I somehow changed the algorithm of actions, but nevertheless, as you can see, it is possible to solve the task this way. We'll be right back. I've repeated the last few actions several times. My job now is to get everything off these two poles. Except this one at the bottom and this one at the bottom. And yet the entire tower of the remaining 6 rings should be standing here. While I'm moving the 5 ring tower back and forth and can't figure out how to do it. The problem is that the final result must be planned so that it is on the right pole. So far I'm doing the algorithm right, but I always randomly distribute these poles here and that's the problem. Okay, let's move on. Yep, yes, it works, it works, it works. Whew. The last step is to move the 6 ring tower to the center. In the meantime, it took me 25 minutes. Just imagine how many moves I've made in all this time. Just a little bit left. That's it, I'm lost. It got mixed up again. I had these cells randomly and that's why I'm lost. It annoys me. I already have the algorithm for the situation when you have a flat tower that you need to move somewhere. But here I just have to put this detail in the center of the tower. And I've been lost I don't know how many times, I even lost count of how many times I've lost. Folks, support me please with like, this is important to me. Because I brought you interesting knowledge, interesting puzzle and you brought me likes and it makes me very happy. Thank you very much for your support. So. Folks, subscribe to the channel and turn on all notifications because in one of the following videos I will show you the most extreme speedcubing videos I've ever filmed. I'm sure you haven't seen at least half of them. So subscribe and ring the bell if you haven't. Yes, the last one is here and it's left to move the 4-story tower to the central pole. That's cool. Here, here, here. Three-story tower, two-story tower here, this way, here, here, like this. Wow! How cool! And it took me 28 minutes and an endless number of moves. Hanoi Tower. Mathematical madness as it is. Folks, the most popular 19th century puzzle I've printed out with 3D printer. That's why I guess I bought a 3D printer to show you this kind of cool historical mathematical puzzles. This is so great! So guys, support me with like and write a comment under this video, what do you think about this puzzle, how many moves I spent on it. And in fact, I'm really glad that in my favorite hobby, I'm starting to discover new and new boundaries. First it was Rubik's Cube, then usual puzzles, then 3D printed, and now the historical relic. You might even call it that, the Hanoi Tower. Is an amazing puzzle, very complex, requiring a huge amount of attention, concentration. I wish each of you to solve it. Just in case you have a 3D printer, I left a link to this model in the description, you can print it out. This is something that each of you guys have to try, this is very cool puzzle. And now the story that I wanted to tell you in the beginning. The story behind this puzzle says that long time ago, in the very beginning of time, the monks of one of the monasteries have committed a sin. The angry god raised 3 high rods, and on one of them laid 64 golden discs, so that each smaller disc lay on each larger one. It was on this Hanoi Tower, but with 64 layers. And once all the 64 discs are transferred from one rod to another, the tower and the temple will turn to dust, and the whole world will perish under thunder. However, there is no logic, why do they need to do it if the world dies? It would be better if the monks free from the guild, but the legend says so. But the interesting thing is that the mathematicians figured out that if the tower had not 8 layers like this, but 64 layers, then the number of discs moved, the minimum number of discs the monks had to move was 18 quintillions, the number like this. And even if these monks worked tirelessly and transferred these discs every day, it would take them 585 billion years to move the entire 64-story tower to the other rod. Cool math puzzle legend, cool math puzzle that reminds me of one fable. I don't remember exactly how it sounds, but it was a sage who asked the king for grain. The king was very greedy and couldn't give much grain to the wise man. But the wise man was much smarter. He asked for a little grain every day. On the first day, he put one seed on a chess field and said that he should give exactly twice as much grain every day. This number he would place on the next cell of the chess field, and so the king agreed and each time gave him twice as much grain. But the number of seeds grew exponentially, and by the last cell, the number of grain was so huge that it was several times the world's supply of all grain. That's it, and maybe I misphrased it, but I hope you were interested in hearing that legend from me. Find it on the internet, be sure to read it, and folks, how great that you and I were joined by such cool puzzles and we learned a little more, at least about the geometric progression. Thank you very much for watching, that was me, Cubastic. Surprise your math teachers and your classmates with this task, I'm sure they will be excited. Thank you all for watching, have a good time.